push me, and then just touch me, till I can get my satisfaction. 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 Satisfaction.
Push me, and then just touch me, till I can get my satisfaction. Satisfaction. Satisfaction.
Do you like it? Like it? Like it? Like it?
Tobacco is a plant that is found natively in North and South America. It is in the same family as the potato, pepper, and the poisonous nightshade, which is a very deadly plant. It is believed that tobacco began growing in the Americas about 6000 BC, as early as 1 BC. American Indians began using tobacco in many different ways, such as in religious and medical practices. Tobacco was believed to be a cure-all and was used to dress wounds, as well as a painkiller. Chewing tobacco was believed to relieve the pain of a toothache. On October 15, 1492, Christopher Columbus was offered dried tobacco leaves as a gift from the American Indians that he encountered. Soon after, sailors brought tobacco back to Europe and the plant was being grown all over Europe. The major reason for tobacco's growing popularity in Europe was its supposed healing properties. Europe believed that tobacco could cure almost anything, from bad breath to cancer. In 1588, a Virginian, Thomas Harriot, promoted smoking tobacco as a viable way to get one's daily dose of tobacco. Unfortunately, he died of nose cancer because it was popular then to breathe the smoke out through your nose. During the 1600s, tobacco was so popular that it was frequently used as money. Tobacco was literally as good as gold. This was also a time when some of the dangerous effects of smoking tobacco were being realized by some individuals. Pierre Lorillard establishes a company in New York City to process tobacco, cigars, and snuff. Today, P. Lorillard is the oldest tobacco company in the U.S. In 1776, during the American Revolutionary War, tobacco helped finance the revolution by serving as collateral for loans the Americans borrowed from France. Over the years, more and more scientists began to understand the chemicals in tobacco as well as the dangerous health effects smoking produces. In 1826, the pure form of nicotine is finally discovered. Soon after, scientists conclude that nicotine is a dangerous poison. Tobacco is a negative effect on almost every organ of the body. According to the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, tobacco use is the leading preventable cause of death in the United States, resulting in more than 443,000 deaths each year. Worldwide, recent studies have shown that tobacco is responsible for about 6 million deaths each year. Cigar smokers and smokeless tobacco, chew or spit tobacco users have similar health risks as cigarette smokers. Secondhand smoke results in approximately 3,000 lung cancer deaths per year in non-smokers. Smoking and chewing tobacco stimulate the chewing user, creating a pleasurable sensation not unlike a high. The effect is generally described as relaxing, although smoking releases a hormone which may create stress in the user. Nicotine is an addictive central nervous system stimulant. When nicotine is taken into the lungs, it is transmitted to the brain in seconds. It causes the heart to beat more rapidly, drawing in and pushing out more blood.
It also makes the veins and arteries constrict, thus requiring the heart to move harder. This results in increasing blood pressure and heart rate. Carbon monoxide is among the many toxic chemicals present in tobacco smoke. It delays the ability of red blood cells to carry oxygen to bodily tissues, including heart and brain tissue. The lack of oxygen causes the heart to work harder and can lead to a thickening of the walls and possible heart failure. Despite the fact that tobacco is a stimulant, the addicted smoker usually feels that smoking relaxes them. This feeling of relaxation is the result of their having satisfied a physical craving.
My take on tobacco is that it is very bad. It makes your breath stink, your teeth yellow, and it can kill you and you can get cancer.
Now, what's your take on tobacco?
Not good for you.
Tobacco use has been proven to cause cardiovascular disease, heart attack, fatal heart failure, stroke, reproductive complications such as miscarriage, premature birth, birth defects, low birth weight, developmental problems, depressive appetite at a time when women should be gaining weight, and reduced ability of the lungs to absorb oxygen. Cancers of the lungs, mouth, throat, larynx, esophagus, stomach, pancreas, uterus, cervix, kidney, bladder, and some forms of leukemia. Pulmonary diseases such as sensitivitis, bronchitis, pneumonia, emphysema, and tracheitis. Increased exacerbated episodes of asthma and respiratory illness among children, respiratory illness and distress, asthmatic and allergic responses, and cardiovascular damage among adults.
Hey Blake, you want a cigarette?
Bro, don't do it. It's bad for you.
Oh, that's so true.
Soon after, sailors brought tobacco back to the Europe.
Start again.
The Europe.
Yeah. Are you sure you don't want to just start it again?
Wait.
There's too many parts you're gonna have to edit.
Pierre L'Oreal. Lori Lard. It's the oldest.
Not my turn again. It makes your breath stink. Okay, go.
Oh, that's so true.
Okay, go.
No, dude, don't do it. It's bad for you.
You can't say.
No, dude, it's bad for you.
Go.